Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. Francis of Assisi American National Catholic Church. And today, we are celebrating the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time and also the Assumption of Mary into Heaven. We are honored to have our celebrant this morning, Bishop George, and we will begin with number 430 in your missalette. Immaculate Mary, number 430. Would you please stand?
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. Your reign now with Jesus, our Savior and King. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria. In heaven the blessed your glory proclaim. On earth we your children invoke your fair name. Our light, your love is our comfort, your prayers are our might. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. Welcome, welcome on this Feast of the Assumption. You and I today gather as Catholics and we acknowledge what the early church had always believed about the quality of the Blessed Mother, that because she was chosen to be the mother of our Savior, she has a special place within our church and within our hearts. And so what you and I do here today, when we honor the Blessed Mother, we honor the dignity of all women in every place and time, and we honor our own dignity as creatures created and loved by God. As we do always, we take a moment to call to mind our failings and our shortcomings. We ask this God who loves us to bring us healing and forgiveness, and so we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. And I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. God the Father of mercies, through the death and resurrection of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, has sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. Through the ministry of the Church, may God grant you pardon and peace, and I absolve you of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Together we join with the archangels and the angels in our wonderful hymn of praise, the Gloria.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
And let us pray. Gracious God, you chose the Virgin Mary to bear your incarnate word, and at her life's end, you brought her in body and spirit to heavenly glory. Grant that, like Mary, we may hear your word and keep it, and one day share with her the risen life of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the ark of his covenant was seen within his temple. A great portent appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was pregnant and was crying out in birth pangs, in the agony of giving birth. Then another portent appeared in heaven, a great red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 diadems on his heads. His tail swept down a third of the stars in heaven and threw them to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman who was about to bear a child, so that he might devour her child as soon as it was born. And she gave birth to a son, a male child, who is to rule all the nations with a rod of iron. But her child was snatched away and taken to God and to his throne. And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she was had as a place prepared by God, so that she can be nourished for 1,260 days. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven proclaiming, "Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of your God and the authority of his Christ." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead also will come through a man. For as all die in Adam, so we all will be made alive in Christ. But each in his own order. Christ, the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom of God, the Father, after he has destroyed every ruler and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. And the last enemy to be destroyed is death. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me and I in him, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? And for as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will be blessed. For the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy,
according to the promise of his according to the promise he made to our mothers and fathers, to Abraham and his descendants forever. And Mary remained with Elizabeth about 3 months and then returned to her home. My sisters and brothers, the good news of our salvation, the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. By the words of the Holy Gospel, may our sins be blotted away.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. It's nice to see you. It's nice to see you. I know it's hot, probably one of the hottest days of the year, right? In so many ways. I think the church, God in his mercy, we transferred the feast from yesterday to today, so I get to wear white. It's a little cooler, right? So as you and I gather for this Feast of the Assumption, we do what Catholics have done probably since the 3rd century. The doctrine of the Immaculate, the doctrine of the Assumption was declared in 1950 by Pius XII as an official doctrine of the Church. But forever in the life of the Church, we have recognized the special place of Mary. In the Eastern churches, this feast is called the Dormition of Mary, the falling asleep of Mary. And so very much what you and I celebrate, and the Church has come somewhat later to, is what we know this as the sensus fidelium, the sense of the people of God, right? Sometimes you and I, from the pews, right? We are leaven in the bread. We are voices in the desert. We are calling to the Church Universal to recognize something that lives and dwells within our heart, right? And so for us as Catholics, it's never been an understanding that we worship Mary. That is not the case ever, right? Mary for us is model of our life and the Church. She is like you and I, and the person of Jesus in his human dimension, in the hypostatic union. But she is as human as you and I are, right? And so sometimes we see this, we see these very kind of beatific statues of the Blessed Mother, which I think for us give us some sense of how we think about her. They're created in our art in many ways, right? But we also have a sense of Mary as an authentic person who said yes to God. And because she said yes to God's invitation, she makes room for all of us, right? And that's why she's maybe has some primacy of place for us, right? And she becomes for us in many ways a powerful intercessor at the throne of God, right? She is not God herself. She would never claim that. Listen to this Magnificat, right? That God has visited the lowliest of his servants, right? And because of that, all generations will be blessed, right? Because God, who she believed, Mary was a devout Jewish woman. She knew the Torah. She knew and was waiting for the Messiah, just like all of her contemporaries in Nazareth, right? And so every Jewish woman today believes that she can be the mother of the Messiah, right? At the breast of a male child, there's a seat for Isaiah, right? Because Isaiah will come before the Messiah. And so every Jewish woman believes this. And so Mary was no different. And so the difference for Mary and for you and I, as she becomes a model of faith for us, is she said yes, right? She said yes. Think about the times that you have said yes to love's invitation in your life. Maybe it has taken you places you could never have imagined, right? And I think that's the case for Mary. The angel appeared to her. She was probably 14 or 15 years old. She was betrothed to Joseph, right? Betrothal was a promise of marriage. It was what everybody in the community knew, right? In the old days, some of you may remember from the pulpit, we would announce the banns of marriage. We would publish them, right? There's a promise of marriage between, right? So everybody knew it. Everybody knew it, right? And so that was, so also people could come in and say, oh my God, they can't get married. She's a reprobate or whatever, right? So in many ways, right? So it was announcing it. So this idea that Mary, right? That she would say yes to this invitation. She knew, by the way, that what would happen to a Jewish woman who was pregnant out of wedlock, right? I mean, can you imagine? What was the penalty, right? They were to be stoned, right? And so she said yes anyway, trusting God, right? So Meister Eckhart tells us that if Christ in the incarnation is continually being reborn in the world, right, then every time you and I say yes to God's invitation to bring love in the world, we can become mothers of Christ. Isn't that an interesting notion? Every time we say that. And you have said it. By virtue of the fact that you sit here today on August 16th, 2015, on probably one of the hottest days of the year, right, is some evidence of your yes to God's invitation to love. We don't gather here because God needs our worship. We don't gather here because Mary needs some special recognition. We gather here because it brings us into community with each other. It, in part, fulfills what God has asked us to do, and it nurtures and strengthens our love so that when we leave here, we can be different, right? We can be love in the world. And so when you and I celebrate the Feast of the Assumption, the fact that Mary was assumed body and soul into heaven, she holds for us that primacy of place and that promise, right? That like Mary, who when she said yes to this invitation to be the mother of Christ, right, the Messiah, the mother of the Messiah, that she didn't fully know what she was saying yes to, but that her faith in God and in God's word and in God's love gave her the strength to continue saying yes, right? Just like you. Every time you have said yes to God's invitation to love, it has brought you to an even greater invitation to God's love, right? At the door of the church, when your parents and godparents agreed for you to become part of the saving mystery of the church, they said yes for you. At your confirmation, you affirmed that yes, right? And maybe again, when you chose to dwell in intimate relationships with someone, you said yes to that, right? And so in all of those yeses is some reflection of the life of Mary that we know. And where has that, right?
It doesn't, once we say
yes to that, we can't say, oh, I changed my mind, right? Let me think about that again, right? So once we say yes, we're all in. We are all in, right? And so it leads us in different places. It has led you to find St. Francis of Assisi. Sometimes it leads us from the comfort of what we know to the challenge of what we don't know, but we cannot say no to it, because it lives within us. It is like a fire within us, right? And so that was Mary. That was Mary. Mary going about her daily routine, I think probably planning her wedding, getting very excited, and all of a sudden, there's the angel saying, you know, and she says, who am I, right? I don't know man. And the angel says, don't worry about that, right? And you and I know the truth of that. All things are possible with God. All things are possible with God, right? And so she says yes. And then that yes led her to a stable in Bethlehem. And then that yes led her to have to flee Israel and go to Egypt. Then that yes brought her back. And then she presents Jesus in the temple, and she hears the prophet Ananias with the Nunc Dimittis. You know, and she holds these things in her heart. That yes led her to the marriage feast of Cana, right? Where we see Mary saying to her son, to the stewards, do what he tells you, right? And Jesus is like, Mom, I'm not ready yet. And she doesn't care, right? So she said, just do what he says, right? So in so many ways. Typical mother, maybe, right? Typical mother, right? So in many ways. And that's what Mary was, a typical mother. We hear the pain when Jesus' family thought that there was something wrong with him, and they were worried about him, and they went to find him and bring him home. And someone announces, Jesus, your mother and your brothers are at the door. And Jesus says, who are my mothers and my brothers and my sisters? Those who do the will of God, right? He was holding up his mother there. This woman did the will of God. She is the model of the church for us, because we move closer in doing the will of God as God has called us to do that, right? And then it leads, and this yes led Mary to the foot of the cross, right? And she's there with Mary, and Mary the mother of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene, and John. And there she is. There she is, right? It led her to the foot of the cross. Her beloved, her child dying in such an ignominious way, and still her faith rooted her there, right? Rooted her there. We have all been there. Each and every one of us have been at a moment at the foot of the cross for ourselves as well, right? But it doesn't end there, right? It doesn't end there. It's the glory of the resurrection. And then we hear in the Acts of the Apostles how Mary was part of the community gathered in the upper room, and the promise that she had waited for all her life, and the Holy Spirit descended upon her. Her yes is our model of yes. Her yes is the model of the church's model for yes, right? We go sometimes in places that we don't know. We walk by faith, right? And so when we celebrate this Feast of the Assumption, we're not celebrating, I think, in any way the deification of the Blessed Mother. We're not saying that she is somehow a goddess. We're not saying that at all. What we're saying is that because of her full humanness, her full assent to participate in the plan of God, God's salvation, you and I have the same opportunity to do that. Every time we say yes, we do that, right? We do that. And I'm telling you, I know it's not easy, right? I know it's not easy. I share with you all the time that when I was studying for the priesthood, I had in mind that I would certainly be in some magnificent cathedral, right? And somewhat of a busy life, right? So, or an easy life, I should say. So this weekend I've married three people. I've had to go down to the shore twice. I've sat in the car. If you could see me in the car, you wouldn't think that I had any relationship with God, especially when I'm in traffic, right? But what I do is in my console is a rosary. And so I take it out and I pray the rosary, right? And so it's in the engagement of that prayer. You know, Hail Mary full of grace, that I also can be full of grace. That in the moment when I have a choice between getting upset and anger, I can choose grace. Because Mary said yes and she was full of grace, right? Hail Mary full of grace, the Lord is with you. God is never far from us, right? God is never very far from us, right? The Lord is with thee. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus, right? So we are blessed, right? When I was a novice, the sisters had their mother house at the bottom of the hill from where our novitiate was. And they were all from Ireland. They said they had the longest novitiate because they entered the novitiate during the war, and the mother house couldn't send them the material for their habits, so they had to stay novices till the end of the war. But they got out of Ireland and they came over to the United States, and so there were maybe about 100 of the sisters at the mother house, and they were many of them in their 80s and their 90s, and so they would invite me down for lunch. I was having a difficult time in novitiate. I had said yes to God's invitation to follow Him. And when I got there, I thought, boy, did I make a mistake, right? And so they sustained me. These women sustained me, right? And so they would have me down for lunch on Sundays. And lunch is always at 1 o'clock. That's one of the commandments in Ireland. You have to eat at 1 o'clock on Sundays, right? And so I would come down and I probably looked a little dejected. I had put on a tremendous amount of weight and I could tell I wasn't healthy. But before I would leave, there's a wonderful tone setting of the Magnificat to an Irish folk song, Run Lassie Run. And so sometimes they would sing that to me, but inevitably they would surround me, right? And one of the sisters would say, Bridget, or she would say, look at himself blessed amongst women, right? And that's often what I feel, right? Look at ourselves blessed. It is women who have sometimes sustained us. It is mother tongue. Our faith is mother tongue. What you and I do is we come and we celebrate the dignity of all human beings because of Mary's yes, right? We celebrate that because of that, you and I have the same invitation. A very dear friend of mine struggled for many years with alcoholism, and he was very close to death. His brother had found him almost drowned. And he was in an emergency room at Jefferson Hospital in Philadelphia. And his mother, who I know is a very strong woman, and had been through many trials. And he's about my age, but this was about 10 years ago. And anyway, he came out of the coma. He came out and was there, and he said, all's I heard my mother saying, and I don't know that she knew that I was awake, my mother saying, dear Mary, please ask your son to help my son. Dear Mary, please ask your son to help my son. Mary becomes for us, right, a powerful intercessor, right? She becomes for us, sometimes for me, maybe for you, in my most desperate moments, right? In moments when I need the affection of a motherly embrace, when I need that feminine dimension in my life, that's who I go to, right? That's who I go to. I don't think Mary looked like these women behind us. I think she was a swarthy kind of a Jewish woman who knew what she was about. I think she was self-confident, and I think she faced the society and the structure in which she was born, and she invited them to go beyond that. She invited them to think beyond these restrictions, right? And that's what always is our invitation, right? Is love invites us to think bigger, right? Love invites us to think in ways that because of Mary's yes, all things are possible with God. So let us continue in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us stand and profess our faith as we say, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through God all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As a people of faith, redeemed by God's love, we offer our prayers and petitions.
Please respond, through Mary, let us live in Christ.
Through Mary, let us live in Christ.
Lord, we ask that the Church, like the Virgin Mary, may bring Christ into the world with joy and be joined with him in endless life. We pray.
Through Mary, may we live in Christ.
Lord, we ask that all mothers find in Mary the example and strength to carry out their vocation. We pray. Through Mary, let us live in Christ.
Lord, bless all women. May they, like Mary, be shown respect and equality. We pray.
Through Mary, let us live in Christ.
Lord, bless the American National Catholic Church and all its people. Sanctify our continued mission to invite all who love you to your altar. We pray.
Through Mary, let us live in Christ.
Lord, may Mary's deep faith and love of you help us to be more loving and open to your ways in our lives. We pray.
Through Mary, let us live in Christ. Lord, please guide leaders of nations to fulfill the needs of the hungry, poor, afflicted, and persecuted, and the lowly by sharing justly the resources and giving them strong respect for all human life. We pray.
Through Mary, let us live in Christ.
Lord, grant that the sick may draw strength, consolation, and healing by turning to Mary, who intercedes for us. Grant us, their friends and family, the compassion to help them find hope and comfort, especially those we now name.
Kathleen and Mert.
Steve and Joanne.
We pray.
Through Mary, let us live in Christ.
Lord, we ask that all who mourn for departed loved ones may take courage from this Feast of the Assumption and find renewed hope and in the promised resurrection. Please embrace those who have died and anoint them with your love, especially those we now name.
Joe Clutter. Ray Daniels.
Ruth Ann and Kathleen.
Barbara and Diane.
We pray.
Through Mary, let us live in Christ.
Gathering our prayers, we ask our Holy Mother to intercede for us, for our petitions as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. My hat.
Please turn to number 616 for How Can I Keep From Singing? Number 616.
Flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation. I hear the real, though far off, hymn that hails a new creation. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? Through all the tumult and the strife, I hear the music ringing. It sounds and echoes in my soul. How can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? Tempest round me roar, I hear the truth it liveth. What though the darkness round me close, songs in the night it giveth. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? The peace of Christ make fresh my heart, a fountain ever springing. All things are mine since I am His, how can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing?
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, that will become for us our spiritual drink. Almighty God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, on the feast of the Assumption of Mary, the Mother of God, accept this sacrifice of reconciliation and peace, that it may bring us pardon for our sins and make our lives an endless thanksgiving. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also
lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Today the Virgin Mother of God was taken into heaven to be the beginning and the image of the Church in glory and a sign of hope and comfort for your pilgrim people. You preserved her from the corruption of the grave, for she had given birth to your Son, the source of all life. And so we join the multitude of angels in their joyful chorus of praise.
Hosanna, Hosanna on high.
Lord, you are holy indeed, and all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, by the working of the Holy Spirit. From age to age, you gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to the setting, a perfect offering may be made to the glory of your name. And so, Lord God, we humbly pray, by the power of your Spirit, sanctify these gifts we have brought before you, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. On the night he was handed over to death, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to all of those whom he loved, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. And handing the cup to all of those whom he loved, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread of life, when we drink from this holy cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, till you come again. When we eat this bread of life, when we drink from this holy cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, till you come again.
Calling to mind, Lord God, the death your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven, and eagerly awaiting the day of his return, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering and see the victim by whose sacrifice you were pleased to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. Let him make us an everlasting gift to you, that we may share in the inheritance of your saints with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles and the martyrs, and all your saints, on whose constant intercession we rely for help. Lord, may this sacrifice, which has made our peace with you, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Strengthen in faith and love your pilgrim church on earth, your servants, the patriarchs of Alexandria, Antioch, Constantinople, Jerusalem, and Rome. I, your unworthy servant, all bishops, priests, and deacons, all ministers of your church, and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Merciful Father, hear the prayers of the family you have gathered here before you, and unite to yourself all your children now scattered over the face of the earth. Welcome into your kingdom our departed brothers and sisters and all who have left this world in your friendship. We hope to enjoy with them your everlasting glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you give the world everything that is good. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen. Alleluia. Forever and ever. Forever. Alleluia. Forever and ever.
Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you.
Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you.
Also,
let us offer each other
a sign of Christ's peace. Peace, Antonina. Marco, peace be with you. Oh, my God. Both.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us, oh, grant us your peace.
My sisters and brothers, this is Jesus, our Lamb of God. This is Jesus who invites each and every one of us into the experience of God's love for us, and how happy are we to be called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. Here at St. Francis, each and every one of you are invited into full participation into the sacrament of the altar. May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Blood of Christ.
Amen.
Antonina, the body of Christ.
Amen.
Marco, the body of Christ. Maureen, the body of Christ. Pete, the body of Christ. Pam, the body of Christ. Joan, the body of Christ. Hap, the body of Christ. Chris, the body of Christ. Joseph, the body of Christ. Ryan, the body of Christ. Body of Christ. Teresa, the body of Christ.
Please turn to number 522. Bread of Life, 522.
Bread of life and cup of hope, we come as gift to you. Change our hearts, fill us with peace, transform our lives anew. Open our eyes so that we might see your presence in one another, your life poured out in love today unites us all in you. Loving Lord, Creator God, open our eyes to see the good that lives in each of us, that called the world to be. And when we fall to see the good, when friendships falter and crumble, give us the courage to forgive, that we may live in peace. Living Word, O Son of God, your love shows us the way, that we may live in harmony and from you never stray. Wipe all oppression from our midst, give us a love for all people. Your song of justice sing to us, to live in peace today.
Please join us in I Am the Bread of Life. It does not appear in your hymnal, but I'm sure you all know it. I am the bread of life.
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever. And I will raise you
I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. Unless you eat of the flesh of the Son of Man and drink of his blood, and drink of his blood, you shall not have life within you. And I will raise you up.
And let us pray. Lord our God, we have been nourished at this heavenly banquet as we honor the Assumption of the Mother of your Divine Son. Deliver us, we pray, from all evil that besets us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
So, happy feast. Happy feast. I read a little article that the 10 things that you're not supposed to do in church, and I think I do all of them. So it says not to ask people if they're new to introduce themselves. So I won't. I don't know. I didn't realize that makes people uncomfortable. Does it? No? All right. All right. Okay.
For a moment.
All right. Right. So, all right. Anybody new? Thanks, Ab. No, everybody. Tell us who you are.
College here at the university.
Sure.
So now I'm back. I'm recently engaged, so I'm looking sort of on the church to fall into with my job. But he lives in New York, so it's hard to
respond. Okay. Well, I hope you fall into St. Francis. We'd love to have you. We'd love to have you. We'd love to have you.
Did that make you feel uncomfortable?
Lauren, was that okay?
No. I'm
faithful. All right. All right. There you go. Well, I felt badly because right at Lauren, I ran out of communion, and so we were sitting there, always the way, right? And then I didn't realize Marco behind me was ready for me. So sorry, Lauren. So because she was just kind of like, "Are we going to do this? What are we going to do?" Right? So anyway, right? So.
So uncomfortable when anybody quotes that kind of article. When anyone quotes that kind of article.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Ab. Thank you, Ab. Thank you. Don't forget. Don't forget our parish retreat. It's a joint parish retreat. All the parishes in Pennsylvania and New Jersey on the 29th. It's going to be here. It's going to be a great day. Please come. It's just please come and relax, and we'll celebrate before we get our busy fall schedule. Right before we get our busy fall schedule. I think that's all the announcements, Joan. Sister Marie. Oh, Sister and Maureen. So, yeah, and Sister. Oh, that's Maureen telling me they're born on the same day. So kind of like, not the same mother, right? Same day, kind of twins, all right? So let's sing Happy Birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Sister and Maureen. Happy birthday to you.
Where's Josephine? Josephine, on Thursday. One more, we'll sing to Josephine.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Josephine. Happy birthday to you.
So I would suggest we sing Happy Birthday to Gidi, but because we've done that every Sunday so far, right? So Father Gidi is covering at Our Lady of Guadalupe today, our sister parish, so that's where he's at today. So pray for him, all right? So I know Marco probably, Mark, come over here. Before Mass, Marco said that he had someone, isn't that interesting? Is that very interesting? And I said, I said to Marco that sometimes when I do Hindu Catholic weddings, that this is what they'll do before the wedding. Marcus said, I'm not getting married, so, right? So I was a little too young for that, right? So other announcements, Leo and Bradley's back, thanks be to God, right? So, anybody else, right? So I'm gonna try to get away a little bit next week, so pray for me, right? So pray for me, and then Father Gidi will be here with you on Sunday. We have a parish council meeting, so come and be part of that if you want, right? So good, all right. My hat. My crusher. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. And may Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go forth from this place in great peace and joy to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'm carrying this crozier today, just so you know, this was made for me by the diocese in Cameroon. And the diocese is dedicated to Our Lady under the title of the Holy Rosary. So they made this for me, and it's a very soft wood, so I don't carry it often, but I think on the Feast of Our Lady, it's a particular export that Cameroon has. It's a beautiful wood. So I just thought I'd share that with you.
My birthday's in December. Nobody really cares. Would you all, one other thing that you're not supposed to do, but would you all do this for me? Just turn to our television camera in the back and wave to all of the people that are watching on YouTube and on Comcast, because we want you folks to know what a friendly bunch we are here, if you haven't figured that out already. And if you would like to join us, and we hope you do, at the bottom of your screen, at the end of the broadcast, will be our website where you can get all the information about who we are, what we do, and where you can find us. So please check it out. And now let's go out singing number 425, Hail Holy Queen, number 425.
And of love, O Maria, triumph, O ye cherubim, sing with us, ye seraphim, heaven and earth resound the hymn, salve, salve, salve.
life our sweetness here below. O Maria, our hope in sorrow and in woe. O Maria, triumph all ye cherubim, sing with us ye seraphim. Heaven and earth resound the hymn, Salve, Salve, Salve Regina. As exiles all to you we cry, O Maria, come soothe with hope our misery.
Have a good week, everyone.